Hi, this is Neil Davis from Digital Cloud Training. In this video, I'm going to walk you through my experience of taking the AWS Certified Solutions Architect Professional Exam recently. Now, I'm sure many of you would love to have this certification. It's definitely a highly regarded certification, and that's because a lot fewer people actually have this certification compared to the associate levels. So it's better regarded by employers and gives you a bit of an edge when you're out there in the job market. Now, I'm sure many of you also know that it is a very difficult and challenging exam. So what I want to do today is give you some tips, talk about my experience, and help you better prepare for your exam so that you can also get the certification. Now, I genuinely believe that anybody who puts in the right preparation with the right training resources and the right amount of hands-on experience can pass this exam. Now, do you actually have to have had lots of work experience? It would really help, but it's not 100% necessary. I know quite a few people who've passed this who don't have significant hands-on experience in a work context. But you do need to get into your free tier account and actually build lots of resources and play around and actually learn hands-on the technology. But you can do that in your own time, in your own space. You don't necessarily need to have had years of experience. Now, I did write a blog article, which you can find on my website. The link will be under the video. Now, the first thing about this exam is it's 75 questions long, rather than the 65 you get in the associate level. So you've got more questions, you've got a bit more time, you've got 180 minutes, but that does only leave you about just over two and a half minutes per question. Now, if you've actually seen some examples of the professional level questions, you'll know they can be quite long. They can be quite complicated, and therefore, that can be a bit intimidating. Now, the first tip that I want to give you is that the length of the question does not equal the difficulty of the question. Sometimes you'll see a really long question with really long answers as well, and it can be quite intimidating at first. I want you to reframe that in your mind, because often the longer questions and the long answers will give you some more clues. You'll be able to use the extra information in there to actually work out whether an answer is correct, whether a solution will work or whether it won't work. So you still need to have the knowledge, but as long as you've got the knowledge, those extra bits of information can often help you. Now, it's a 75% pass mark, so it's a bit higher as well than the associate levels, which are at 72%. So you've really got to get lots of answers correct, which means time management is super important. Now, the good thing is, though there are some really long and complex questions, there's quite a few in there that I found I could get through quite quickly. So every four or five questions, I'd get a question that was quite challenging. I'd probably spend a few minutes really thinking it over. But in between that, most questions I found I could answer fairly quickly. Now, don't rush it too much, because they can be quite devious. So you've got to be careful that you've read every answer correctly and every detail of the question itself. Now, in terms of the actual question types, you've got multiple choice, which is where you have one correct answer out of four options. And then you have multiple response. Now, for the multiple response questions, what I've seen mostly myself and what I know from other people who've taken the pro level exams is mostly you're going to get questions that have five answers, and there's two answers that you've got to select correctly. And then the other option is that there might be six answers and you've got to choose three. Now, again, don't let it intimidate you. Sometimes the multiple choice questions with just one answer can be the hardest. And sometimes the ones with three options that you've got to choose can actually be the easier ones. So again, the difficulty does not necessarily correlate with either the question length or the number of answers. Now, as I mentioned before, time management is super important. You know, you really don't want to get down to the last 10 minutes and realize you've got several questions yet to answer, because under time pressure, you're going to make mistakes. These questions are pretty difficult. They can be devious, as I said. You've got to be really careful that you've read the question very well and had enough time to consider it. So make sure you're moving through. Don't get stuck on one question for too long, because that could cost you more points at the end. Give it your best guess and then move on. But mark it, and then hopefully you've got a bit of time at the end and you can come back and give it a double check. Now, in terms of the actual content on the exam, I got some tips in here, but I'm not going to walk you through all of those. But what I do want to tell you is the style of the exam is it's an architecture exam. So what they want you to really understand is solution architectures. Now, that means how do multiple services work together in a solution? So you'll get questions which test your knowledge of how you connect different AWS services together and how they would work together in a solution. You'll also find that the professional level exam tests your knowledge of multiple accounts and multiple region architectures. So you've really got to know your networking, you've got to know about how to use databases across regions. So for example, you need to understand how you can have a multi-master database where you can write to multiple regions at a time. And in which circumstances would you use that? How would you do DR between different regions? And you need to understand how to have multiple accounts. AWS organizations comes up quite a lot, so you need to know how to secure them and how to get cross-account access working between different accounts. So lots of that kind of thing are coming up, and you really need to know this stuff in depth. Also, lots about migration from on-premises, so you've got to really make sure you know your migration tools. Now, in terms of preparing for this exam, the first thing I want to say is it's not required, but I highly recommend that you've done all of the associate certifications. You'll find topics in the exam that are found more heavily in the developer exam than the solutions architect exam. You might find some scenarios that come up, which if you've done the SysOps exam, it will really help you to better answer those questions. So unless you've got a load of industry experience working with the same technologies that are covered on the exam, I would highly recommend doing all three associates first. Then, what resources can you use to study the extra knowledge you need for this exam? Well, there's some great articles on AWS, FAQs, as well as tutorials. In terms of courses, I used some of the major courses that are out there from the known providers. I didn't find any of them really covered everything, but there was quite a bit in there, so there are some good resources out there, but you've got to make sure that you cover all of your bases. Now, I'm going to try and do that in the course which I'm releasing very soon. I'm going to make sure that I cover everything which I've seen in the exam and gathering the feedback from our students as to what they've seen in the pro-level exam as well to make sure that we've got a fully comprehensive course, so you only have to go to one place. Now, the practice tests were the challenge. With practice tests, I didn't find anything that came anywhere near the type of questions which you find on the exam. I used a provider which had a set of 300 questions, but they were nothing like the real exam. So very quickly, I realized I was wasting time there. Time is important, guys. You know, it's gonna take a long time to prepare for this exam. You gotta put the effort in to really get your skills up to date. So you don't wanna put time into things which are wasting your time. You gotta make sure you're using the right resources. Now, I've released a set of practice questions recently, so obviously I favor those. I think you should have a look. They're a smaller set of questions, but I'm concentrating on quality, not quantity here. It's all about making sure that the very scenarios you're going to see on the exam are covered in the course. And so those are out now. There's more questions being added every day. I'm continuing to write questions, so I'm sure that will cover all bases for you. So in summary, the Solutions Architect Professional Exam is definitely challenging, but it's achievable for anyone who puts in the right amount of effort. You've got to get the right courses, the right practice tests. You've got to make sure you do lots of hands-on labs. Practice, practice, practice. You can't just do the theory for this particular exam, guys. You've really got to get hands-on. So you must do all those things and just make sure you're ready before you sit this exam. It's really tough. So make sure that you have got yourself prepared, your head's in the right space, and go in there, think about time management, do your best, and I'm sure you can get through this exam. I look forward to hearing about your success.